Hello and welcome to this tutorial where I'll showcase you the Terrain Remix Brushes add-on. It's an updated version of the Terrain Brushes add-on for Unreal Engine. And it basically allows you to create realistic looking terrains in a matter of minutes. And in this version, you're also able to scatter vegetation and rock assets. And there's also a material system which allows you to blend different layers like snow, rock, grass and gravel in a realistic way by using erosion details. So this tutorial, it will just cover the basics of the functionality of the plugin, but I'll create some other videos, one for explaining how to create your brushes with custom height maps, and two other videos for going over in much more detail the material and the scattering. By the way, I will release this add-on alongside with the Blender add-on, and if you buy, you get access to both. And yeah, I'll just jump right quickly into the tutorial. Okay, so first thing first, you go into Edit Plugins and you look for Landscape. There you make sure that the Landscape Patch plugin is enabled. It's gonna tell you to restart the engine, and once you've done that, you create a new level and you go into Landscape. From Landscape, you make sure that Enable Edit Layers is enabled, and I'm gonna add a material. One from the material presets I added to my plugin, and I'm going to select default, and I'm going to make sure that I'm working with a resolution that's okay. I think 2000 is a good compromise between detail and performance. Click on create, and now you're going to make sure that under paint here on layers, the first two, erosion and rock, have a non-weight blended layer assigned to them. So I'm just gonna create one for each of them. Save, and now you make right-click, clear layer, right-click, clear layer, perfecto. You go into selection mode, and let's start working with our brushes. Okay, there's three types of brushes. There's peaks, slope details, and valleys. Peaks are basically mountains. Slope details, they cut into the terrain and they raise at the same time. They're more used for areas with low detail or flat areas. And valleys, they cut into the terrain to create valleys. Voila. So, first thing, I think I'm gonna add a peak. Just you can see the first time you add a peak onto your terrain or a brush onto your terrain, it's gonna bring up this window. You just click on accept and you see the mountain appear, but you need to do it a second time for it to actually appear here in our outliner. So let's see, what mountain can we pick? Maybe let's try this peak 6, drop it in, and here we can, just as you would with regular meshes, you can move, you can rotate, and you can scale. You can also just scale on the x-axis to make your mountains taller. And as you can see, there's also a material which automatically updates based on how we move our brush. And it creates basically snow on the higher altitudes. It adds rocks under this on the steep slopes. It adds gravel here with this erosion detail flow lines, and it adds grass to the flat areas. So let's try and create a terrain with these brushes. I think here's a problem which can occur sometimes if you scale your brushes too big, is that the value starts clipping of the height map. For that, you go select your terrain. Under scale, you make sure that it's not locked, and you change your Z scale to something bigger, like 500. Then you go and you move your peak. Okay. There's another very fast way to change the look of your terrain, and that's by changing the material. You can try some of these material presets. And to change them, you need to select your landscape. scroll down onto landscape material and then drag and drop the preset onto the terrain, onto the landscape material slot, I mean. And you can see this drastically changes the look of our terrain. There's the masks for the gravel, the change, the color of the grass, the color of the rock, the snow mask, and this can be also edited further to fit the look of your terrain. For example, let's change the look of this default 8 preset, and let's change the hue maybe to 5.055. Can change as well maybe the color of the rock or the gravel. Right now maybe let's make the gravel a bit lighter, turning the lightness to 3, and same for the rock. And say we want some snow, for that we go into snow and we change the snow mask. Let's enable it first, and voila, we've got some snow already. We can change how much snow we have, if it's snow, only snow at the top of the peaks or all on our terrain. That's just a very fast way to iterate on the look of your terrain, and I will create a second video where I'll go over all these settings in much more detail. Right now I'm just gonna go for the default 3 material and go back into the next topic, which is scattering. So for the scattering, there's also a folder, scattering, voila, and you have got these different types of assets which can be scattered on the terrain. I have rocks and the vegetation right now. And if we take a look at the rocks, we drop one into the terrain. We get this little box with rocks inside. Now if we change the scale of the box to something bigger, like 150, you can see there's gonna be more rocks scattered all on our terrain. And you can change a lot of these settings even further by going into PCG components and scrolling down under parameter overrides. There's again a lot of different settings which I'm also gonna create a video for where I go over them in much more detail. Right now I'm just interested in disabling the bounding box, which means it's gonna scatter all over the landscape. Just right now we've got too many rocks here in this area with snow, which looks a bit strange because the rocks are not covered in snow. So I'm just gonna use a feature. It's called the tree line. Now, of course, trees and rocks are different things, but I'm using tree line as a term because usually it's useful for trees, because trees stop growing at a certain altitude or start growing at a certain altitude. So right now I'm interested in the upper tree line, or rock line in this case. I set it to 5000. You can see the rocks are stopping to scatter at a certain altitude. Exactly what I wanted. So let's drop in some medium rocks as well. Go into PCG component, change the tree line to 5000 and disable the bounding box. A lot of medium rocks on our terrain and the small rocks. Let's do the same. First the tree line, 5000, and then disable the bounding box, because once you disable the bounding box, it's gonna take a while to compile, especially the small rocks, which are gonna be much, much more in number than the big rocks. There you go. All the rocks have been scattered. As you can see, the performance is very good, and there is no distance culling, so they don't disappear at a certain distance. That's because I'm using nanite for these meshes. And yeah, the performance is perfect, I would say. Now let's look at the vegetation. Now in the project file, I've included vegetation with a very basic low poly look. That's because I'm not a very good vegetation artist. But for the example of this tutorial, I've created some different, I know I'm using some different assets, which I found, I think, on the marketplace and on the internet. I will link them in the description. And for example, we have this fine scattering here. And you can see it's scattered a lot of different, very nice looking trees on our terrain. Following a few basic rules, right now it's following the tree line. For example, the trees stop growing at a certain height, they start growing at a certain height, and they don't grow too much on areas where there's a lot of erosion, like here in these gravel flows. And there's also some noise applied on the terrain, which makes the trees grow on certain areas and not others, to make the look a bit more organic. So I'm also adding a broadleaf scattering device. It's taking some time as well because it's scattering a few more trees. There you go. There we have our broadleaf trees. Now if I press G to make these bounding boxes disappear, to go into game mode, switch to full screen, you can have a look at our completed terrain. As you can see, the landscape remix brushes are quite easy to use, and they have a lot of potential for creating good looking terrains in a quite fast way. I hope you're gonna enjoy them, and if you have some feedback, please leave it in the comments. And let me know also if you have some ideas of what can be added next, or of what to change. And please check out also the other videos if you want to learn more about how to scatter and how to color your terrain in more detail. And see you next time.